does such a meaningful, biological, special program start? A person suddenly experiences a situation in which a basic biological need of theirs is threatened. One which is unexpected and is perceived as highly acute, dramatic, and isolating. That means they unexpectedly lose control of the situation and feel alone with the threat. The situation represents a so-called biological conflict for them, which will in turn initiate a meaningful biological special program. Whether the situation fulfills these criteria for them depends on their individual perception of the situation, which is determined by their ideas and beliefs, abilities, education, culture, social integration, the biological code of the human species or respective animal, and much more. A variety of things influence these internal frameworks, and they therefore probably also act as the interface to many other health-promoting models. Someone who keeps his body vigorous through healthy nutrition and sports, or who is always mindful and dissolves old, rigid beliefs through spiritual techniques, will be less likely to perceive threatening situations as a biological conflict, necessarily meeting all three criteria: unexpected, highly acute, dramatic, and isolating. The trigger for an SBS is thus the subjective, conflictive feeling of a situation, not what happened objectively. While one person perceives a situation as a biological conflict, the same situation can be perceived by another person as insignificant, exciting, or even funny. Take, for example, suddenly losing one's job. If the person has a good education, close friends with whom they can stay for a while if necessary, financial security from their family, as well as high self-esteem, the situation is certainly uncomfortable for them, but will probably not result in a biological conflict. If, on the other hand, they are financially dependent on work, they have no family to help them out, little education, making them anxious applying for jobs, then they are in a position to meet the unexpected, highly acute, dramatic, and isolating criteria. This situation for them is much more likely to be perceived as a biological conflict. Or take the example of the elderly man who has gone into a retirement home because of his wife's passing. Let's say he lived for 60 years in the same house that he personally built. His wife had cooked for him, and he has always had difficulty connecting with other people. Having to move to a retirement home can therefore easily be perceived as a loss of his safe environment or as an existential fear. For others, the conditions may be completely different. One has changed apartments every 10 years and makes new friends easily. Another can provide for himself and the grandkids live very close to the retirement home. A third has been preparing for this situation for years and has already chosen a facility for himself with especially loving caregivers. Therefore, there are no biological conflicts for any of them. It is therefore impossible to judge from the outside whether a situation will lead to an SBS for a particular person, since every person is unique and has very specific internal and external framework conditions. Bypassing the conscious mind, these factors determine whether a situation is instinctively perceived as a biological conflict and which special program is then started. But conversely, one can always be sure that each SBS must have been preceded by a very specific, conflicting situation, even if the situation itself is highly individual. Each biological conflict deals with a certain kind of threat or instinctive feeling, depending on which basic biological need is threatened. This is called conflict content, and determines which SBS is started to solve the conflict, always synchronously on three levels: psyche, brain, and organ. In the psyche, there will be compulsive thinking about the problem in order to find a solution as quickly as possible. We can barely sleep and have a hard time concentrating on other things. Changes in the brain can be objectively assessed using medical imaging techniques. Dr. Hommer made extensive use of this possibility in his research. Once he found that all persons with similar organ activity also show visible changes in identical locations in their brains. In the context of each more intense SBS, a concentric pattern centered on the associated brain relay is visible on the sectional planes of CT images, a phenomenon known as a Hommer focus. Depending on the tissue type, there is an increase or decrease in the function of the associated organ, which leads to cell proliferation or cell loss, given unbiologically long conflict times. There is always a logical connection between each tissue and its conflict content. The bladder mucosa, for example, is sensitive and tells us how full the bladder is. This enables urination, in the animal kingdom, to mark one's territory. The content of the conflict, therefore, is that you are unsure where your own territory or its boundaries are, or where you can mark, so that it is recognized and respected. The territory can be, for example, the apartment, the partner, the workplace, a club, a car, etc. The voluntary muscles serve to perform vital physical tasks. The conflict content of muscle tissue is therefore about not being strong enough to perform a motion. The sensation here is failure. That is, for example, a narrowly missed goal that was perceived as important because the strength was insufficient. At the psychic level of the SBS, timeline changes are visible immediately after the biological conflict. By contrast, at the organic level, it may take weeks or even months for the functional changes to become problematic cellular changes, which lead to increased symptoms. This time lag led to the idea of the psyche as the cause of disease, as one can often observe how a person with an altered mental state eventually develops severe physical symptoms. There is, in fact, a connection between the psyche and the organ. However, the change in the psyche is not the trigger of the organ changes. Both are parallel symptom levels of one special program that was started by a biological, instinctively perceived conflict. Ideas such as stress or bad thoughts lead to illness are therefore incorrect. It may lead to focusing efforts on combating mental symptoms, even though they are but part of the adjustment mechanism whose purpose is to bring about a quick and effective solution to the conflict. Thinking away the problem is therefore not possible. The synchrony of the three levels, psyche, brain, and organ, enabled Dr. Hommer to precisely research this model, and is an important foundation for the science of new medicine because if 1,000 patients experience a growing tumor of the liver cells, one must also find a Hommer focus in the brainstem of those same 1,000 patients, centered on the control center for the liver, as well as a psychological feeling and behavior of starvation in each of them, since at its root, we are dealing here with a so-called starvation conflict. Correspondingly, you will find a liver tumor in every patient showing a Hommer focus in their liver control center, and their thoughts will be preoccupied with starvation anxiety. Theoretically, you should also be able to deduce the other two levels from the psyche. However, since the psyche is not measurable, such conclusions are extremely error-prone and therefore of little relevance. All this is encapsulated in the first biological, natural law, which summarizes the following three criteria. Each meaningful biological special program is activated by an isolating, dramatically felt circumstance. This activation is not psychic in its nature. The nature of the unconscious sensation of the biological problem determines which specific meaningful biological special program, SBS, is activated. The SBS always runs simultaneously on the three levels, psyche, brain, and organ. Until now, we have not had a plausible explanation for why a particular person has a specific symptom at a specific time in their lives. We asked ourselves, why me? Why now? Why this? It was clear that symptom-based therapies were developed and administered almost independent of the personal circumstances of individual cases. By knowing the meaningful special biological programs and the first natural law of biology, we and our tumor patient now understand exactly why me, why now, why this symptom. There are still some open questions, such as the sidedness of the symptoms, that is, left or right side. These will be explained elsewhere. Up to this point, however, the tumor patient does not yet know whether there are new, more targeted ways of dealing with the symptoms so that they can recover as quickly as possible. Concrete first approaches to this are provided by knowledge of the way an SBS unfolds, which will be discussed in the next part.